The Nobel family made great fortune selling dynamite and weapons. They were not respected by their contemporaries because they were profiting on the suffering and killing of others. To remedy the situation, Alfred Nobel founded the Nobel Prize, and from then on, 5 prizes of 1 million each would be given every year to those who during the preceding year have conferred the greatest benefit to humankind. So let's see some examples of those, quote, who have conferred the greatest benefit to humankind. Number one, Mr. Obama was awarded Nobel Prize for Peace, being the president of the country which is involved in wars and military interventions more than any other on earth. Wow. Interestingly enough, he was selected as possible nominee before he even served any meaningful amount of time as president. Actually, at the time he was elected as such. For example, a person who doesn't need any further introduction got the Nobel Prize for environmental merits, which did not go beyond making one video on environmental subjects. Actually, everybody was suggesting people like Nikola Tesla and Mendeleev, who compiled the periodic table, to become Nobel laureates. However, that didn't happen. Instead of that, the council gave Nobel jackpots to people like, for example, an Austrian writer, a certain lady with hereditary psychological problems, and her work is described by the critics as a weird blend of pornography and sadism for children, I believe. And all we have is the opinion of the critics and not of the public, because the public never read her books, actually. But even after all these fiascos, in the minds of the masses, the Nobel Prize sounds like something glamorous and respectable, and people are ready to believe that some otherwise unknown to them person is a genius just because he or she got the Nobel Prize. For example, most people believe that Albert Einstein was a genius because of his explanation of the general theories of relativity. Actually, many use his name as a synonym for genius. The theories and the formulas of the general relativity were put forward by Hendrik Lorentz and Jules-Henri Poincaré. And Einstein, who at that time worked in a patent office, decided to take personal advantage of the discoveries of others. This type of behavior was not highly appreciated by the contemporary society. There were scandals. But still, he was given the Nobel Prize for his explanation only, of the photoelectric effect. Yes, explanation only, because the effect as such was discovered and described by the Russian scientist Alexander Stoletov, but the jury of the Nobel Prize was somehow not interested in the original inventor, but they wanted to hear about it from Albert Einstein exactly, and that's because of the scandal. Einstein was supposed to get the Nobel Prize for the general relativity theory, but the contemporaries figured out the fraud quickly, and that's why they did the Nobel Prize jury. They did the fraud with another discovery, the same trick. And the trick worked pretty well in the long term. Now most people are under the impression that it was Einstein who discovered the general relativity and the photoelectric effect. Despite the abundant evidence that the Nobel Prizes are not really given to people who have done the best for humanity, still, till date, when people hear that somebody has got the Nobel Prize, immediately they are inclined to worship that person and believe anything he says without the need of verification. And as long as people wish and agree to be defrauded, there will be no shortage of those who wish to take advantage of such global minds. That's why they are expanding the program of the Nobel Prize. Now there is a prize in economic sciences introduced recently by the Swedish bank. The jackpot is the same, 1 million, and this time it is for saints of the TV religion. That is the religion that whatever I hear on TV is correct. The magic mantra of that religion is the scientist said, and whatever follows after that phrase, people take as indisputable truth. It works very well in herding, and that's why the people who invent newer and newer methods to tighten the shackles of the enslaved human race with all kinds of financial regulations and money tricks. Now they are also crowned as scientists, you know, prize in economic sciences. And then they, these jackpots are so that these scientists can buy expensive suits. They look even more respectable in front of the TV cameras, and when they speak about the next upcoming financial reform, actually most people, they do bite on very small and insignificant bites and end up voting for politicians at the end, which do make everything worse. And they do not vote for the sincere politicians, because as I have covered many times, we do have such politicians as well, but it is the people who do not vote for them, deceived by the glamorous looks and expert word jugglery by the economic saints. Interestingly enough, that these saints, when they do their own businesses, they don't conduct it on the principle that they preach on TV, but they use institutions like, for example, the Bank of the Vatican, which deals in extremely large amounts. And interestingly enough, the only way to pay in and out is by cash or in gold. And as the living conditions of those who have trusted the economic saints get worse and worse, the frustration of the masses grows, and they still don't get it. How could have I had good intention and voted for somebody who promised me good, and still the result is bad? So where did it go wrong? It went wrong when they did not stop trusting the Nobel Prizes, one out of the many examples, when they saw the reports that this is all fraud and it is all meant to artificially inflate the prestige of persons or theories which usually would not have been accepted by the people under normal circumstances. But people cannot lose faith in the Nobel Prize in general, no matter how much evidence they see that it is all farce. Because if they decide not to trust the Nobel Prize and don't even care about it, that will automatically mean that mostly everything that they hear on the media is absolutely untrustworthy. And that is the problem. That is what people cannot do. Another even better example, people get sick, they go to doctor and they get mistreated, and in many cases the doctors make it even worse. Very often such type of patients will even read that chemical medicine is actually quite harmful. There is often much more harm than use of going to the doctor. But still, they will simply change the doctor. They will not abandon going to doctors altogether, no matter how many times the doctor actually harms them instead of helping. That is because of this childhood upbringing, this fear to jump into another paradigm. Actually, people have become so narrow-minded that many of them cannot even understand what does it mean to have another paradigm in life, another reality. They cannot imagine how would that be practical? Just because since childhood, the only thing they have seen and heard about is being part of a technocratic society and educate oneself only to the extent to which you can do some sort of job, which in its turn will be part of this giant mechanism of technocratic existence. Here in this video, those who are curious may hear about the other type of reality. And in this one, in the second part, there are practical step-by-step instructions how to shift, how to make this transit from the reality in which you see yourself as a victim of oppressive government and become the master of your own life instead.
Thank you.